this show. It's a great show. I think that you'll like this show, too. I like salad, too. I had a great salad the other day. It had a little baked potato, cream cheese, and chives. Hunting is pretty cool, too. But it all depends on what you wear.
No, wait! Cut! Almost alive from WOAK, it's the Year-End Show!
To the greatest scientific breakthrough since the Elvis Presley beach doll. How much would you expect to pay for this offer? $10? $5? But wait, there's more! If you place your order now, you'll receive at absolutely no extra cost to you an additional 3 pounds of packaging material. But you must act now. Be the very first in your block to be taken in by this television offer. Send $19.95 plus $3 postage for the handling to TV offer, Post Office Box 101, New York, New York, 47600. For rush orders, call 1-800-TV-OFFER. Visa and MasterCard accepted. Allow 3 to 6 years for delivery. Void where prohibited.
Excuse me, Biff.
Yes?
Do you expect to find the perfect woman?
No, but it's a lot of fun hunting.
Oh,
from the dark ages, in a time where evil was strong and good was at its best, there came the legend of the Ginsu. Long ago, there was a magical sword. A sword that could change the cooking life of the culinary world if it fell into the wrong hands. What do you know about the Ginsu sword, Winu Lu?
All I know, it's being guarded by two Oriental Jeffs.
I don't care who guarding sword. I want it. Ow.
What's so important about Ginsu?
It is only most powerful tool for slicing and dicing veggies. And anything else I can think of. It is said, he who control Ginsu sword will rule the Kuanawi world.
Hey, you want to fight? Then fight me!
Theater to bring you this special bulletin. A UFO has reportedly landed in the telecommunications classroom at Dondero High School. Do we have a signal?
Apparently.
Hold on, we seem to be missing our video signal. Do we have cameras? Are you there?
I don't know.
Did you take the cap off the camera?
No, hold on. Stand by.
We should have video.
You're taping, right? Did you do a white balance?
No.
Ready?
Yep.
Okay. Here we are, at a high school in Royal Oak, where a flying saucer reportedly made a landing in the telecommunications studio, and we're the first ones here to investigate. Let's go in.
To Ginsu Theater, where more fighting has taken place.
Theater to bring you more news of the UFO sighting. Apparently our investigator has now entered the building. Let's go on the scene, shall we?
Hello? Where are you going? Come on, let's go. I think it's in here. No, that's not it.
During our absence, Wei Nu Lu went out for some Chinese carryout, and upon his return walked into an attack by the jealous chef and felt a wrath of his deadly sharp sticks.
In the studio, and in just a moment, we should be seeing some surprising stuff.
In here.
Who are you?
A special organization investigating alleged aerial phenomena and alien technological concepts.
Oh, psychopaths.
Yeah. Where's the victim? What happened?
I was ran over by a flying saucer.
What did the saucer look like?
It looked like a cigar.
I think he's gonna die. He has expired.
Wei Nu Lu has developed a style of his own. Kung Shu.
Has returned, and something reportedly has happened to our investigator and cameraman. Let's go on the scene.
Let's see if we can get some answers from anybody else in this class. Did you see anything? Wait. Did you see anything?
I saw a light. It was bright, and it blinded me.
Obviously something he needed. Never mind. Let's move on. Hey, what did you see?
I saw everything.
Great. Here, fill this out. Just forget it. This is a very unusual sighting. As you can see, the saucer came in the tracks. It was a Type D9. I think the UFO is returning.
We now return to give a credit where credit is due.
Lost our signal with our investigator. It looks like something has happened to our cameraman. We will send more people to the site and update as news between a girl and a horse?
I don't know.
You must have had some great dates.
I met her at a bar. We went out twice before, but then I tried. Sigh. Three months of a perfect marriage, gone. I don't know what to do. It smelled good. Sigh.
Oh, Butler.
Yes?
How's your brother doing in the hospital?
He's all right, but I don't think he'll be home for a while.
Why? Did you see his doctor?
No, but I saw his nurse.
There's a group in America today that has systematically moved into every facet of life as we know it. This group has surprisingly subtle control over our lives. In fact, rarely a day goes by that each of us does not acknowledge their existence. Please welcome our guests today. They are with us.
Thank you, Phil.
Firstly, how did they become as powerful as they is?
I, speaking for the community of they, that is, we being they, have for years been blamed for the inept mistakes of others. They did it. They screwed it up. And finally, we, being they, decided to take responsibility for the reactions of others before the mistakes were made.
But how can you justify taking over the lives of not only others, but each of us as individuals?
But Phil, there are no individuals. You are either they or you are others.
How can they say what they is saying? Who do they think they are? I think what he's trying to say is, who do you, being they, say they are, they being you, of course?
We, they, are all except the others.
Who are these others?
This organization of others is constantly attempting to upset the fine balance and the immense public service we, being they, do.
Example?
They say this man robbed the bank, but others said that he is innocent. They, being others, across the board contradict what we, being they, say.
it's clear that they is very good at what they does. We always hear somehow what they say. How do they get out what they say to others?
Actually, despite our they's best efforts, others do not find out what they say. Our releases are meant for the general public, not for others to reshape and attempt to discredit us.
You just said that you are either they or you are others, so how can you, being they, say that what they say is meant for the general population and not for others when you are either they or others?
Firstly, Phil, we have to go to a commercial break now, but to answer your questions,
I'm sorry. We'll get your response when we come back. They say we have to go to a commercial break now. Stay with us.
Oh, Beth.
Yes, Kip?
Did you know I'm going to get married as soon as I find my opposite?
Really? Then tonight I'll introduce you to a girl who's good-looking, intelligent, and well-cultured.
There's three things in jogging you should never do. Number one, jog with combat boots on. Number two, never jog with your mouth open, because bugs aren't one of the basic food groups. And number three, never let them see you sweat.
See what happened to Annie? He forgot to put on the all-new, not quite sure, but there's a possibility deodorant. Available now in scented and unscented scents.
Oops.
Oh, Skip.
Yes, Beth?
I'm putting everything I know into my next story.
Oh, I get it. A short story?
Suicidal Express. This was made by the same people who brought you Faces of Death.
This is a movie show of suicides that actually happened on live TV, if you can believe it.
I can.
I can.
Okay. Let's take a look at the first clip. Worse than the first one.
What are you talking about? Oh, man.
It's terrible, camera.
You do not know the true art of film.
God, give me an
idiot. Oh, I'm an idiot. Well, you know what I think about your mother?
Second person. Well, fine. Just roll the next.
Now that was great. You have to admit that was more realistic than the first two, in your opinion, I guess.
All right. Okay.
It was better than the first. We're gonna let it slide this time. It's about time, man. This guy has nothing to do with about movies. No, you have no idea. You have no idea what you were doing. Anyway, just watch us next week when we'll actually have the entire film.
So until next time, we'll see you at the video store.
Basketball's a game for the big boys. It's a game that takes skill, talent, and a good pair of shoes. Air Jordan shoes aren't just any shoes. It's a shoe you can trust. If you want to dunk like Michael Jordan, you have to start with a good pair of shoes. Air Jordan shoes, the shoes that put a lift into your game.
Dear consumers, I'm sure none of you out there would buy a product that would hurt you or even kill you after only one or two uses, would you? Well, some of you have. The product is Psych Cologne. Psych Cologne has been clinically proven to be extremely hazardous to your health in a numerous amount of tests. Please, if you have bought Psych Cologne, dispose of it. If you have used Psych Cologne, go see a doctor as soon as possible or call our newly formed hotline, 1-800-ANTI-PSYCH, for more information on this deadly product.
That's right, Norman's back, and he's not at the Bates Motel. He's now got his own magazine. No, not Mad Magazine, it's Psycho Magazine. From the makers of Fangoria Magazine comes the newest, the hottest, the hippest, and the most creative ways to slaughter your neighbors. Yes, Norman has come up with a real beauty here. You can get 12 bloody issues for $8.95. Now that is what I call a deal. And if you order within the next 48 hours, you will receive our special welcoming book. It's a look back at all of the greatest mass murders of all time. You'll also receive our special videotape that has many clips from the greatest slasher films of all time, available on both VHS and Beta. Now then, if you don't think that's a great deal, you should be shot on the spot. But we won't have any of that. So just to prove that this is such a great deal, we'll also give you this free starter chainsaw. Yes, I know you can't believe it, but you get the 12 issues of Psycho Magazine, the free videotape and book, and the free starter chainsaw for just $8.95. Act now by calling toll-free 1-800-KALTHEM. That number once again, 1-800-434-8326. Our operators are standing by for now.
Ah!